Let's talk business now. Early this year, the Zambian government increased the CDF funds from 1.6 million kwacha to 25.7 million kwacha, that is about $30 to $460. President Hakainde Hichilema promised the people themselves should decide how they want to develop their areas. Now, in Livingstone constituency, there are complaints and questions on how the money is being used. Lydia Makina has more in this report.
With questions going around with how CDF money is being shared and what is being used for, the Livingstone Member of Parliament, Rodney Sikomba, and Livingstone CDF Chairperson toured the ongoing project which is being funded by CDF. Earlier this year, government increased the amount of money it gives to the constituencies to spend on development projects. Mr. Rodney Sikomba says he's happy to see how the work is going on well and it will soon start operating. He said CDF is meant to grow a Zambian community by funding projects, empowering community members, and this is one of its use.
We came here together with our colleagues from the CDF committee, the council itself, and obviously the local community here to see how far this project has gone. One of the many projects, water projects that we're doing within the constituency, this is one of them that has been completed, and sooner rather than later, it will be officially handed over to the community. The challenges that the people of Nsongwe were facing was that there was one borehole which was very far away from the community itself, and apparently there are some certain sectors of the community that felt that they owned the particular borehole and denying other people access. So the CDF committee found it fit through the WDC of Ushungu Ward to actually construct this hand pump. Now, this is the start of the many initiatives that the constituency will embark on together with the council. In as much as we've gotten this centralized borehole here, hand pump, what we want to see is water taken to the household. This water needs to go to the homes. We don't want people to be leaving their homes to go and draw water. It takes a bit of time, and as you are well aware, this particular area of ours is more of very close to the game park. So we don't want people to be in conflict with the animals which are around this game park. So the next phase or the next course of action is that we're going to have a project that will now have a centralized water reticulation system that will feed into the households.
Meanwhile, Livingstone CDF chairperson has asked the community to guard the hand pumps jealously and put on security measures.
So, well, we are proud that the water is now closer to the people and that people have water. As a measure to safeguard it, we are encouraging the community to build something around this borehole so that it can be secured from vandalism. That is our message to the community. We are happy the headman is here. I'm sure the headman has taken this advice.
Community members of Songwe Village expressed happiness and thanked the New Dawn government that has made them access water nearby, as in the old days they could walk a distance just to fetch water.
So to say, we are happy concerning with the borehole that we have been given here. So what is remaining is the solar that is going to be put on here. So we don't know how we're going to arrange with the security on the solar system. We are happy with the information of how the drill balls and tank solar panels and tank that are going to come. We'll be very happy if the project can speed up.
Reporting from News Central, I'm Lydia Makina.